Hi, welcome to Be Inspired with Dominic. And in this quick and dirty, I'll show you how to make this kind of tray in the dimensions you need and from scrap. You can use them as shadow boxes or as part storage for the workshop. Oh, and there are also these.
I will use this stack of thin slices left over from another project. You can use virtually any scrap you have as long as they are wide enough, which depends on what you need this for. You can find more details about getting the right dimensions in the description. I want to make a tray to store pens in, so that is the rough dimension I'm going with. There's no need for a snug fit, so I will be eyeballing most of it. While I cut these pieces to width, let me point out that I'm making something for my shop, so beauty is secondary. This is why there will be little sanding and not an overabundance of precision in this video. This is about getting the job done. But you can use this technique to make beautiful things if you plan ahead a little, sand what needs sanding before the glue up, and remove squeeze out where necessary. Speaking of glue up, this is what we will do now. I have two different widths of pieces. Here you can see that the vertical ones are a little bit longer than the flat ones. To glue them up as shown, I bunch up the bottom pieces and spread glue on one side all at once. Then I flip them over as one and add glue to the other side. To minimize the mess, I placed them on sacrificial pieces for that, but using clamps to hold them would have been even better. Here's something I shared on Instagram. Glue needs spreading on two sides. I use quick clamps not only to hold them together, but also as feet for when I do the second side. Then I put them together as shown and tighten the clamps. Thing is, if you over-tighten them, the middle section might come up and jump all over the place, accompanied by a few choice words if you're so inclined. To be able to use the clamps properly, I add two additional pieces and two clamps to keep this from happening. Maybe you spotted the problem. Use something that the wood glue does not stick to on the bottom. At the very least, use packing tape. Now I determine the last dimension of this tray, the length of the compartments. For me, that is a pen. Then I cut the proto tray to that length. After cutting the first side, I use that as a measuring stick for the second one. To close up the tray, I need three more pieces. They have the same width as the vertical pieces, but my stock was not long enough, so I have to cut extras here. These will go between the slices and on the sides. You can of course do more than two slices. But before, I remove the worst tear out with a bit of sandpaper. To make spreading glue easier, I apply too much glue to one face and distribute it from face to face till they are all evenly covered. Again with the clamps, and for a shop project, I call it done.
And here we have the, shall we say, finished thing. It's obviously unfinished because this is about the technique. You could easily slice it apart a little more or, well, do a number of things to make different geometries or smaller compartments. This is what I made my first one for. This is for my pen turning. Basically, I'm taking this around in my shop, starting, say, at the miter saw to cut the stock to size, then over to the drill press and so on, just to give you an idea how you can use these. If you think this technique is helpful, please share it with your friends, it would mean a lot to me. And, as always, remember to... Surprise! I spray painted this one. But I also used this technique for something else. And here they are. Of course, sold separately, or not sold at all. And yes, they're also pretty rough, but they see use in the shop.
This is a variation of the technique shown before and uses thicker stock between the compartments. This allows me to slice them apart and turn them into single boxes.
Here's what I'm using them for. You can see I added cleats to two sides so I can hang them like this or like this. Just another idea for you to use this technique, and now I let myself remember to be inspired.